guys, and today we are going to be doing this as a tour and showing y'all how to be doing it. So,
is there anything
Justin
and I can do to help you?
No, we're not really doing anything fancy. We've got a couple of salads and
okay.
Steaks, and that's about it. I mean, green salad. I'm not cooking rice or potatoes or anything.
All right.
But anyways, yeah, I just got some pasta salad, some green salad.
Sounds perfect.
Some of my kale salad. I got fruit salad too, so that's an option.
Yeah, that's good. That's really good.
It's me. I mean, you need to go get something else.
Okay.
Sure.
No, we ate about 1 o'clock.
Okay.
So, well, maybe it was about 1:30. But we had brunch. We go to the Melia's, which is Melia's is a whole block of buildings. So it takes up almost the whole city block.
Yeah.
So like there's a Melia's barbershop, there's a Melia's.
Oh my gosh.
That so the Melia's restaurant is in that same building. So it's really neat. It's a historic building, and then the waiters there are always really charismatic. And
is it Italian or Italian or just?
Oh no, it's American food.
American food.
Like
Melia's.
Not Amelia, the Melia.
Oh, the Melia. Oh, the meal.
Yeah. Mills or something like that. The Melia's. It was really neat, and the waiters there are really charismatic. One sat there and told us the history of the building, and then the other one was just a character himself. So
he was kind of awesome, though.
Yeah, he was kind of funny.
You thought he was cute.
Giggle.
So,
it's great. You didn't catch on to that.
Amelia's liquor store. Amelia's.
Yeah, the Amelia's is in Gilroy off of 6th Street. It's a historic building, I guess, and it used to always be a bar. It started out as a bar and saloon, but they had underground tunnels, I guess, underneath the restaurant that went across the street. So anytime that, you know, they tried to raid him for liquor, they would just go down the elevator shaft and go down and run across the street so they could never bust them.
Oh my god, how weird.
Yeah, but then I guess at one point when the sewers went in, they blocked off the underground, rooms.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's really good, and it's pretty neat, a neat restaurant.
Yeah.
And the brunch there is all we've had. So we've gone there for brunch several times, but they do a pretty good job. So there's one across the street, I think it's called Courthouse Restaurant or something, right, diagonal from the
Is that on the corner?
Uh-huh.
I think I've seen that.
Yeah, so we're going to try there next time because it looks really good,
that
too.
Looks really nice, yeah.
Yeah. My last week of 8 a.m.s until January.
8 a.m.s?
Yeah, getting up and having to be at work at 8 a.m.
Yeah, really am.
Yeah.
What did I ask you?
I don't know.
I mean, how's the house coming? Have you been there since it's been raining?
Yeah. they're moving on little things, but, you know, they can be done really quick or they can drag it out.
Yeah.
And so I'm just like, you know, come on, you guys.
Yeah,
you
know?
So yeah, we've been over there, and it's they're moving along with some things, and other things. I haven't gotten out of the car in about a week but they have everything right, and all the electricals run.
Really?
All of the plumbing's done. They've got all the archways in.
Right now, it's just wood studs and framing.
So. I'll take you over there sometime if you're interested.
Yeah. That's good. so you got some.
Yeah.
Insides.
Yeah, yeah. The insides are nice and big. I mean, it's a small place, but it's really, it'll be perfect.
Yeah.
I mean, gosh. No, no, more stuff to have to clean. Thank you. More yard work to do, and you know, all the other stuff, so. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm hopeful because I've got the fridge, and I told them, I said, you know, I'm buying this now, but I can't have it delivered. You know, and they were like, that's okay, we can probably hold off for a while, and they said, right now, we'll schedule it for December the 26th.
Okay.
We need to push it out a little bit more.
Oh, really?
Call us back and push it out.
Okay.
But at least now you have it, and it's set aside, because they only have like 23 units left in their entire store, so they was like, well, 22 left, and you know, our sale ends on the 26th. And then I walked into Costco and the guy was trying to sell me solar roofing stuff, right?
Right.
And I looked at him and I said, okay. And he goes, well, what's your address? So I gave him the address over there and he was all, oh. I said, oh, what? I told you, you know, what the situation is. Well, you have to come back once it's built.
Well, you think they.
Thanks a lot.
I said it's like a
1,400 to 1,500 square foot 3-bedroom house. You know, you should be able to say, okay, in general, with that, we can do this, and if it's a tile roof, we can work with that. No, we couldn't do anything until my house was actually, because the two houses done, I can't do the court. And I said, okay, thank you. Yeah, because I mean, I'm interested in it, it's exciting, but you know, I know that the PG&E can be a killer, so. And now I have some strange man following me home. It's my bed.
Follow you home. Don't cross this line.
That's right. The line of the sand is here.
Yeah, really. Right where the pit bull is.
That's right. That's right. Both pit bulls are, yeah.
See that line? This guy's watching it.
Yeah. And he's kind of unpredictable, you know.
Yep.
Oh, well, he's unpredictable to me. He's not been unpredictable to me thus far. That's good.
How does he run Wayne?
He barks at Wayne.
Really?
He's good. He's good with him.
Who got him? Who raised him? You or Wayne?
No. Well, he was raised by a female basketball player from UCSD.
Oh.
And then she took off and left him for about 3 months with her roommates. So he was kind of babied and kind of weird. So number one, he thinks of the bathroom as a safe space. So if you have a bathroom door open and you say a cuss word like that real loud, just at anything, he's in the bathroom. Yeah, just shaking like a leaf. So he hides in the bathroom. He likes to eat off forks. He didn't know how to eat out of the fridge when he first saw him. He just was like, because she had been spoon feeding him, I figured out, you know. Yeah. And so there was that, and he didn't know how to pee like a boy. He went outside and he's all, you know, I'm like, how was that working out for you? You pee all of this stuff, I can't, because he just didn't know how to pee. So he missed out, I think, on some critical dog skills, you know, because I think she sent me a picture of him when she first got him, and he was like only 4 weeks old. Like, he was too young. You can see it. She had him over her shoulder like this, and it was just too young.
Because they raise their young.
They don't experience or whether it's a biological
experience.
It's
a
say
sign.
Types of things, you know, like the morals behind it.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, the ethics that have come out of the different things that have already taken place.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we did humans the week before that, and then we went on to animals.
Yeah.
It's interesting the differences between how people view people versus the animals. You know,
uh-huh.
You know,
sure.
Living things. That's been my argument. So I make great
arguments.
Well,
not only that, but how different cultures view different animals.
Right.
You
and
know, whether
they're
dogs or cats or cows, you know.
Right, right.
You know.
Like in Asia,
like
they
like
have
us,
dogs.
We value dogs. We go to
right.
Europe and,
right.
You know, dogs are competing, you know. So.
Right, and in Asia, they have that thing where they scare them once a year and then they kill them while they're scared so that they get the better meat, they say. And so they do that in Asia, somewhere in Japan or somewhere they have this dog festival once a year.
Yeah,
they scare them on purpose and stress them out and kill them. So it's a big human rights thing. So, you know, of course, it came up.
Human rights.
Well, animal rights. I call it human rights, but it's animal rights.
Yeah.
But, you know, living things. Why do you want to terrorize them? And then there's the Kobe beef, where they massage them and want them to be super relaxed and enjoy themselves, and then that's how they kill them.
Yeah.
You know? So.
Exactly.
Take one before or after dinner. Serena?
Okay.
Before or after?
After. I do
okay.
This.
Right after dinner, we're going to take one.